And there's the cab.
Going somewhere?
We are going to a new area. Yeah, there it is. Grout's Mansion. I actually thought we'd be going to... not Grout's Mansion, but... we'd be going to Hollywood, but it looks like we're going to Grout's Mansion, so that's...
Where to?
That's fine, too. Just drive, man. Just drive up here. I'm gonna actually take a screenshot of this at some point, or at least freeze the video, and equate this to real life. Because I mean, this is a real map. I just want to see like where we are in terms of real life and stuff. I don't know why. Just got it. Alright. Kind of curious where Grout's Mansion is. Yeah. What are you doing here?
You. What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? Yeah.
No.
Oh, alright then. It wasn't really a yes or no question.
You should get out of here. This place is bad news. Pardon me.
The music's the same as the hotel. What's inside? That second line, I like the theory of it, but the way it's said is so cheesy and horrible. Maybe it's part of the setting, but I really don't like it. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Well, I guess I asked him to wait. I better get a move on. You know, the meter's running. Okay, big mansion. Well, obviously, you know, it comes with the territory of it being a mansion. I get that. But as far as mansions go, it's still pretty big. Though I know you guys have like many big houses in America compared to you know, most of us here in the UK. But even so, that's a big ass house, basically, isn't it? You know, even by anyone's standards, I'm sure. But yeah, just in general, I feel that the average American-sized property is larger than you got more land, really, and you know. It's rolling up, I guess. It's all aboard the freak train. Here we go. Oh, this place is. I knew this was gonna be weird. Hello. Nice outfit, by the way. I keep forgetting how to. There we go. Yeah, let's have a look at that. Something about it doesn't feel quite right. Something isn't quite right, apparently. Why do you all have to be weird? Why are there no normal people around here, you know? I suppose there are. They're wandering around on the street. And I bite their necks to drink their blood, so... Oh god, there's a puzzle in this room.
Another unfortunate casualty to Tide of Time, insane asylums. I lament their loss not only as brokerage houses for the breadth and depth of human psychoses, but also I shall mourn the disappearance of that peculiar environment present only in an insane asylum. That palpable atmosphere of blistered brains and churning bowels, the odoriferous mélange of freely flowing bodily humors, that gently rolling cacophony of distant sobs and screams, the muttered cursing at perceived enemies, and the blissful gurgling of the lobotomized, like a newborn babe discovering the sky. I shall still find test subjects as surely as I find bloody sustenance in the night, but this climate, I fear, may never be replicated.
Very wordy, isn't he? So this dude likes in sail asylums. He's got a very nice speaking voice as well, I have to say. And decided to replicate one here. I have gained an unknown. There it is. Perhaps you should finish eating soul donut? You need research search of at least two to use this item. Our research is 5. Don't get it. I thought our research was pretty good, and it is. Oh, okay. Wait a minute. Now I know what it is. It's this. It's a thithel. A sithel. When I was younger, I couldn't pronounce sithel, and I kept saying thithel all the time. This petrified reed was not meant to fall into the hands of the damned, but vampires can benefit from its shamanistic magic. All the same. Increases defense by 1 point. Ah! Does it? I keep floundering around like an idiot. Yeah, so it's gone up by 1 point, as we can see. Just like on its own. Alright, good. Good, research skill is good. Perception at once shapes the mind and rules over time. Time, however, erodes human perception and then in turn warps the mind. The mind is capricious, having various effects on perception, time, and the mind itself, with harmony, progress is made. An hourglass. Let's leave that for now, I guess. Oh, hang on. Time. Perception. Okay, I wish I knew where that was. Oh, totally. And I guess the mind. Alright, yeah, I totally solved the riddle. I totally solved the riddle. I just solved the riddle. That's what I did. The riddle was there, and I solved it because it was a riddle to be solved. And I thought, well, how do we solve this riddle? And I figured it out in my head and did it without even really, explaining it or having any effort whatsoever into it, because I solved the riddle. Oh, bad person. Bad people. Am I just gonna assume that you're all gonna be hostile? I guess so, huh? I was gonna let you live. It'd be a case of better safe than sorry now, though.
It is quite peculiar, the happenings I've been made to witness for my supernatural longevity. I am thinking of one unfortunate phenomenon in particular, of unique interest to my station, both as a professional and as a sufferer of this vampiric condition. It seems the stream of time has begun to erode the moorings of my chosen course of study, for the methodologies that gave birth to psychology are slowly disappearing. I find myself in an era that overlooks the physical component of psychological pathology time and again in favor of the sophistic practices of Freud. Phrenology, dactopintalism, and the rest of the old guard has fallen by the wayside, its champions all silenced in death, with my unique exception. Would that I could make my voice heard again, although it may be suspicious should I return to popular medical discourse 50 years after my apparent death.
Yes.
No, better that I continue my studies into the psychoses in secret. One day, may I hold up my own cure as validation of the methods. I am confident no cure for my condition or that of my beloved wife lies within our figurative minds, waiting to be unlocked by the correct combination of memories recovered from our childhoods. And I'm most certain it has nothing to do with the relationship between myself, my parents, and my genitals. Sorry, Sigmund, but I choose to stay my course. In time, too, may your star fade and disappear.
Something against Freud there. Well, is that him? This is who we're looking for. Is it a very high-res picture there? Now, the interesting thing is here, of course, these look the same. So maybe they're not as important as we might think. Nevertheless, worth remembering. Something very vampiric about you, you know? You're a very weak vampire, and yet the way you move and such. Just. Not all the way, because that will make me lose humanity and stuff. Well, that matters, I guess. But, she's had enough, Cassie. She's had enough of these shenanigans. Oh, I see that. I see that. Just make sure that this chair is dead first, right? Whoa! What? Alright. Well, that's good, I guess. And this is the door that we opened, is it not? No, it isn't. I thought I was around here somewhere. Oh, this is. Yeah, okay, this was the door we opened, so this is. Actually, I don't think she cares, so. Ah, okay. Open this. Very steep stairs, good to say. Ugh. It's weird. Get in the corner.
Often I reflect with great regret on the missed opportunity that was my infector. Had I been conscious after the attack, I could have stopped the orderlies from locking her in the roaming pen. What I would give for just one interview, a few simple questions of the plague-ridden woman who met her end that dawn. Of course, there is no guarantee she would have been any more helpful than my current crop of test subjects, mewling wretches. Few could be called enthusiastic. Given the nature of the tests, I cannot expect the same fervor from all, but a modicum of cooperation would be appreciated. Animals, The one called John went so far as to gnaw off his arm and escape into the floorboards like some feral rodent. I still hear him scurrying about at night. He must be making an atrocious mess in there.
Gotta watch for him. Ooh, a lady. A very nice table, I gotta say. It's one of the nicer tables I have seen so far in the game.
My studies proceed at a languid pace. I'm mired in a foul ennui as my wife's illness advances. My subjects grow restless without proper supervision, but I cannot pull myself back from this black depression. How many nights I've wasted now, gazing from the tower walk, pondering the frailty of existence.
Wow, that was a quick one. All right, so we're piecing together a little thing here. There's got to be a chest under here. Ah, oh, there's always a chest under the stairs, game. Why do I think this is going to lead absolutely nowhere? No, it actually did. It actually led somewhere. I thought it was going to be one of those climb it. And never, ever find anything. All right, well, we've got a very nice view of the city. I love all the, you know, simulation of the cars and the streets and everything. You know, for the time. Very nice. Alright then, well, he's been up there, because I guess that was the tower walk, pondering the pointlessness of existence and all that. Just get out of my way. You'll get fat, Cassie. Think of the calories. How many pints have you consumed? There must be a point where you can't drink anymore. I know like vampires live on blood, but you know, humans need water to drink, but you can't drink 17 pints of water. You'll die. And yet here we are. All right, hello. Tell you what. Now I can use powers and such. One, two, three, four. I'm stuck on a thing. It's really irritating when that happens. You get stuck on a pillar or something. I can't possibly get past here, you know. But we made it. We got a little bit of damage there. I'd have actually done that better if I'd stick with my fists, but oh boy. Alright, fine, I'll use this. Ah, okay. Pretty sure I died before that. It was due to our knife. Or fist or whatever.
After decades of solitary study into this affliction, I have learned that it is by no means mine alone. Indeed, the city is home to an entire society of similarly afflicted individuals with whom I've only recently made contact. They are an understandably standoffish sort, by and large, but I have been able to confirm with them that the condition is indeed vampirism, which apparently comes in a multitude of strains, each with a spectacular set of symptoms such as invisibility and even a sort of lycanthropy. Through numerous official interactions with the governing body of this secret society, I have concluded that their fundamental understanding of the vampiric condition is woefully lacking and mired in suspicion and pseudo-religious dogma that would make a Turk balk for its strictures. Indeed, they seemed impressed with my studies and the eloquence with which I was able to present them. Apparently, the typical sufferer of my particular strain of vampirism is far from the vanguard of the King's English. So impressed were they that they even offered me an office in their government, a rather high office by the sound of things, I believe I shall accept. If nothing else, it should provide a lofty vantage point from which to observe the breadth and epidemiology of the affliction so that I may move more expeditiously toward a cure.
So he's indeed looking for a cure for him and his wife, it seems. Came down here, didn't I? All right, so... blood everywhere. So big fight in here, yada yada yada. They go this way. This way leads back into here. Maybe I've unlocked somewhere. That opens that. Might as well leave that open. How do we remove these locks here? We now open this, leads back into here, and then we can go this, and that leads. Found now. This is curious, though. Could just well be a glitch. I mean, it does seem like an absolute mirror of this room, so I don't think there's a room beyond there that looks exactly the same as this one. You never know, I guess. It's definitely a mirror. Well, a bulletproof mirror, but yeah. That's where we entered from. If in doubt, shoot it. Shut up! I'm just gonna eat them all. But yeah, we've solved this riddle. Totally solved it. Just solved it. Completely solved it. It's solved. And that opened this, so you can get in here. He said he was up there on the walk quite a bit, you know, the tower walk, which is where we're heading now. doesn't look like there's anything up here. Don't know how, if I should question how you get up there. Death, which then leads back out here to where we started, more or less. Well, I'm stuck. I know I'm walking past the answer a couple times. This tends to be what happens. And then this room just leads, well, it is this, isn't it? This is it. What the? Ha! Alright then, I knew there was something up with that. Never mind. Progress. Whack me, you git. Oh, now we're up here. Right. And if I open this, that will get down there with the ladder. Chaos, like the mind, can be understood only through the scientific process. Order, however, I thought it was a D, is only as good as the perception thereof. Time is the key that links the two and bears witness their ebb and flow.
I have accepted the role of Primogen. For Clan Malkavian, the dreadfully winsome label applied to the particular strain of vampirism I suffer, so named for some supposed vampire father figure of old, or poppycock grown from a backward culture that seems interminably drawn to children's tales and the fiction of Victorian romance when it should concern itself with the science behind their suffering. No matter. For I have taken this office for no greater reason than to advance my research. I must make mention, however, that even among my would-be peers in this governing body of vampires, the level of paranoia and superstition is frightening. Their intelligence is not the question, no, indeed. As they courted me for this appointment, I had to suspect that their overtures were hand-tailored to what must be my obvious infatuation with reason, for the devil would do well to have such honey-tongued tempters. Even so, I could not help but notice the dressing of language these vampire leaders chose for their siren song. Whether it is born of habit, from addressing their unwashed, ill-educated subjects, or from their own deep-seated beliefs, their linguistic flourishes belie a faith in superstition over the providence of empirical reason that must be an all-pervasive theme in this society of darkest night. Damn it all, now I'm doing it too.
So he got a different insight on things, hasn't he? Okay, that's where we came up. Although that's where we're supposed to go. Oh, freaking ladder, man. Yep, ladder. Brilliant ladders, brilliant. This is where we need to go. Let's give it a save. Because it has been a while. Oh boy. Ah, there we go. That's very elaborate, isn't it? How much power that costs to, well, what his electricity bill must be for that, you know? Yes, we couldn't get in before. Because reasons. Okay.